Good day, I'm your humble narrator Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Batman Arkham Asylum on that there PC, and I'm getting seriously fucking sick of those teeth. Good fucking this is another one of those bits that I can't remember how to fucking proceed. Oh, hello. Got a tape.
Patient's name is Victor Saz. For the record, the patient has transferred from Dr. Cassidy, who is on leave after the incident last week. Hello, Victor. Please, take a seat. Guards, you can leave us.
Sorry, Doctor. Warden's orders. I can't leave you alone with him.
I understand. Hello, Victor. How are you feeling today? Victor? I can't help you if you don't speak.
Depressed. Does that help you? Can you get into my mind, Doctor?
Why depressed?
I'm just thinking about the one that got away. The one I chose. I needed the mark. I want the mark!
Good to know he's still completely fucking sensible and not at all a raving madman. Okay, so that guard's got a name, but this one doesn't. I kind of feel sorry for the one that doesn't have a name. The one that doesn't have a name. Sorry, I don't even know if this will do anything, but I think no, that won't do anything because that just unlocks that. Okay, I've just wasted my time. Eh, fuck it, I don't care. Open up, you bastard! Come on! Come on! Open up, you bastard, or start flailing my arms at you! Hi! Fucking stop that! Kind of weird. It'd be great if I'll punch you, Harley! But it'll be great if inexplicably Max Shrek from Batman Returns was in here. Just cause then, you know, we could have Batman Arkham Asylum with Christopher Walken! Like, really, goading Batman, not a good idea. By any stretch of the imagination, goading Batman is not a good idea. No matter how fucking confident you are in your abilities, you do not want to goad Batman. You know why you don't want to goad Batman? Because it's fucking Batman! Ah, we've got the Two-Face room. There's no point in me talking about Two-Face. We all know about Two-Face. It's the thing, I don't read Batman, but I don't read comics and hype! How's your mother? This is the game trying to be startling.
Victor has been more subdued recently. Response to medication has been poor. Hello, Victor. Is there anything you'd like to talk about today? Victor!
This is going nowhere. Guard! Get him out of here! You heard the doctor. Get out! Didn't you hear me? He's got a knife! Ah! Get a trike in him! Oh, God! He's on Bill! He's cutting him! Get him off! Get him off! We need help here!
Okay, where's the loony bin? I wonder, will that blow up all of them? Hi, skeleton. Oh, wait, wrong one. There we go. He knocks them out in such a calm way. I'm trying to think, which one of these had the fucking... Which one of these had the trophy in it again? Oh, no, it wasn't you. I know one of these has a trophy in it. By the way, if someone could please explain to me how exactly the Riddler is getting behind fucking ancient fucked up walls without destroying them.
Thank the Lord! I thought you'd have found that 1 hour ago.
Well, given the fact I only just got here, that would have been difficult now, wouldn't it? Given the fact that I'm also not actual... I like how the Riddler thinks that Batman is here to do the Riddler trophies and not just here because the fucking Joker's trying to kill everyone. Like, he specifically thinks that I'm just... What? Let me just get Mr. Freeze here.
You are beginning to impress me, Batman. You may...
Is the Mr. Freeze design... Yeah, even the Mr. Freeze design is very similar to the look in Arkham City. A bit more steampunk, though, I'd say, that design is. Or rather, kind of 1950s.
Excellent. I'll leave it to you then, my dear.
Get up!
Yeah, leave it to her, Joker. It's not like you're entirely fucking certain that she's gonna lose or anything. Hey, don't you fucking try and hit me! That's rude, right? Oh shit. Okay, there we go. Yeah, it's your own fucking guy who just who got that in the face as well.
Get him on the ground and stomp on his face. All you have is that.
Fucking. You know, if you actually...
Turn up
now, see, the damnedest thing is about this whole section. No, fuck that. Oh, please get the guy who's got the fucking... Yes, I got the guy who's got the most dangerous weapon right now. Cool. I am perfectly okay with the guy with the most effective weapon being knocked out. That is not something that bothers me in the slightest. Hey, buddy. Come on, man, I'm just knocking out. I'm just trying to knock out the dude who's carrying a fucking shock baton. I'm getting the timing wrong on some of these punches, I think.
He's done it again. I don't believe it. I'm on my way now.
Oops, change of plans, kiddo.
But I tried my best.
Sorry, but there is no prize for second place. I'm afraid you're off the party list. Better luck next time.
No! Die, you big ugly bat! That's my party list.
Quiet. Why the smiles next to certain names?
You're the detective, you tell me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Harley Quinn, one of the least effective of the Joker's minions.
Subdued, and I have a principal.
So you can find the secret lab in the gardens.
Yes. Harley's been everywhere on the island, so I'm calibrating the scanner to only show prints that have traces of chlorophyll.
Okay, listen. Be careful. I rerouted a Wayne Tech satellite to show thermal scans of the island. The gardens are showing up hot. Something bad is happening there.
Now you see, if I'd done the model for her skeleton, I would have quite literally... Fuck off, map. I would have quite literally just put, like, little spikes through where her pigtails are. But that's just me. That's just me being weird, I suppose. Right, where's the... So, there's one that's got a trophy in it. I'm trying to... Fuck it, I have to go upstairs and hack something anyway. Let's just go. Oh, Riddler map. I don't even fucking use the Riddler maps. I just use them for the fucking experience. Or the bats, as it were. Where's my cryptographic sequencer? There we go. Oh, we got another tape. Let me guess. Zaz? Yep, thought so.
Luther has been in isolation since the attack on Zagar last week. As I wait for him to be brought up to me, I have had time to review his notes. I am increasingly worried. He cannot be cured. He has no empathy for his victims. Deep down, I believe he views all of us as potential victims.
Doc, are you okay?
What's happening?
Meet Zaz. He broke out of isolation. He's gone.
Oh, God!
Don't worry, Doc. You're in the safest place. He's definitely left the island.
Of course. But someone needs to alert the authorities. He'll need to kill again. Do you understand me? Needs to. Oh, no. He's gone after Dr. Cassidy.
Hello?
Sarah, it's Gretchen. Listen to me.
Hold on. There's someone at the door.
Sarah, do not answer the door. Can you hear me? Do not answer the door. It says he's free.
Well, at least we didn't get to see, well, at least we didn't have to hear the grisly murder. Now, frankly, that would have probably been very cheesy. Just, oh no, I'm being stabbed! Oh! There we go. So I wonder how much, like, damage Batman on his own is doing. Like, well, I wonder how expensive this security system is, honestly. You know, this one, the Batman's just fucking blowing up every 10 fucking seconds for the rest of the game. He's gonna be disappointed, isn't he? Oh, spirit of Arkham!
I returned to my work, but I could not shake the pictures from my mind. I should have been repulsed, but I was more eager than ever to find an explanation for why someone would do this.
Sorry, just fucking... My dog heard someone outside. Just started barking. It's just the weirdest thing, my dog. When she's about to start barking, she starts huffing. Like, she just, like, starts puffing her cheeks out. Just, and that's when he can tell us, like, no, doggy.
How did you get out of there?
Easily! Because I'm the fucking Batman! Look, this is what you... Where are you? Is that you? Is that you over here? Look. Oh, I'm not sure if I've mentioned this before, but I'm the only person who sees a kind of similarity in the design of Harley Quinn in this game, and, what was her name? Juliet, I think her name was, from Lollipop Chainsaw. I like Lollipop Chainsaw. I know a lot of people hated Lollipop Chainsaw. I like Lollipop Chainsaw. I'm just trying to remember where we have to go. I think we have to go back now, don't we? Yes, we have to head to the Botanical Gardens. Open the door so I can get my fucking fat bat face away from the glass. Oh yeah, just don't let me jump over that or anything.
Harley was just the warm-up bats. And to be fair to the little scamp, she did an okay job. Let's call it a B+. But between you and me, I'm aiming for the A grade. Just come to mix a couple more of these chemicals, and I'll be creating my own personal army.
Okay, good, there's not a dude in there. There, I always have to check to make sure whether or not there's a dude in there. Cryptographic signature. I think we will actually be able to open up something, or to get to, somewhere, shop. Shortly. Or actually, no, it just occurred to me. I think we also need think there's like this one place in this area that's been my fucking the bane of my existence for entirely too long. And if I remember correctly, we need the cryptographic sequencer with both the upgrades and also an item we don't get to the botanical gardens. That probably explains why I've just never picked the fucking thing up, frankly. Because I just can't be arsed going back. That's the thing, every now and again I have like started up saves of this game. Like saying to myself, I am gonna find all the secrets. And then I just don't, because I don't care. Like the only, I think there's like precisely one game I've ever 100%ed. That's at all a challenge to 100%, and I think that was Spyro 2. It's the only game I ever 100%ed. Not even Spyro 1, Spyro 2. Batman ain't dead. I'm fairly certain I'd know if Batman was dead. That would be an interesting twist on this game, though. If it turned out that you haven't been playing Batman, but you've been playing as a kind of rip-off Batman. You've been playing as Owlman from that one DC Universe film. You know what? While we're here, that's a that's coming along nicely. Nope! God damn it. So it'll just be able to run away. Oh well. But let's have a look. Let's have a bit of an old chat with Uncle Jay, shall we? See what Uncle Jay has to say. Oh, he is looking fancy
let's
there.
Let's talk about employee relations, Bats. Harley disappointed me, and now she's out of the picture. Gone. Forgotten. Dead to me. You get the idea. What's it like in your organization? Do you punish your hired help when they fail you? Or is that saucy outfit you make him wear punishment enough?
It's always been a bit worrying that Batman insists on dressing a young orphan boy in spandex. That's, that's a bit of an issue. Especially when you then remember, or when you then consider, like, it, like that honestly kind of makes, the Joker's insistence on, I presume the Joker's insistence, actually I don't know, Harley may very well just dress like that herself, but when you look at the way that Harley dresses, somehow that's less obscene than the way, Robin dresses, just because she's a fucking grown woman, you know? Bang.
You do know how to read a map, don't you, detective?
Hi. Knock these fuckers out. Not exactly the most efficient fighting force in the world, you must admit. One hostile, unarmed. Where? I don't see him. Oh well. Just keeping our merry way to the gardens, methinks. Is Arkham North where I want to go? Okay, yeah, I want to go, like, through Arkham North to the Pentagon. Okay. Never occurred to anyone to lock this door just to stop me from advancing. Hi. Good night. Don't mind the cape physics fucking up something or other. Hey!
Satisfied with your
I fucked. Seriously, don't trust the Joker about anything, dude's a nut job. Okay, seriously, the fact that he can fucking summon up an army baffles me to this day. It's like, who is doing what this man says? He fucks over his own, dudes constantly, and fuck off! These guys aren't really a threat, they're more of a fucking irritation than anything else. You know, you're trying to get some work done and suddenly you're getting fucking humped by a madman wearing an adult diaper. Not good. To fucking try, it's easy to understand how Batman could be, you know, traumatized as fuck. Is there anything in here? Oh, yep, there's this.
Take patient interview 20. Joker is more interesting than I originally believed. When Project Titan is operational, I believe Joker will be the perfect test subject. Good afternoon. Today, I thought I'd skip back to our previous conversations about your family.
Of course. I was born in a small fishing village. I always wanted to join the circus, but my father wouldn't really let me.
I don't believe you.
My father was a cop. 1 week from retirement when the mob...
I've seen the movie. What are you scared of?
Scared?
Yes, scared. There's obviously something. Something that made you what you are.
What if I'm too scared to... It's too much.
Then I can help you.
I'm kind of glad that they never 100% explained what the Joker's backstory is. I mean, having said that, it's always just kind of been assumed to be the Killing Joke. If I remember correctly, they retconned the Killing Joke out of the canon. Like, they made it. I think they, like, afterwards, like, long after... The Killing Joke was released. When they re-released it, they made it an Elseworlds story, as opposed to just a normal Batman story. Just to kind of make it not really what happened. But I've heard so most people always accepted the Killing Joke, but... Eh. I prefer the idea that the Joker... I mean, even in the Killing Joke backstory, he says that he doesn't know his own backstory, and that isn't necessarily how it happened. No, and I like that, you know, I like the character being mysterious. You know, I believe I've already said this at some point in this Let's Play, but you know, a mystery, once a mystery is solved, it's not interesting anymore. That's one of the things I like about the Holders series, is that for the most part, it's never fully explained as to how the Holders, the objects in the Holders work. Because the minute you explain that, they lose a lot of their mystique.
Private notes of Dr. Young. Titan is a success. Even my funding worries have been solved after the unexpected donations from Mr. White. Joker has also shown a remarkable interest in the possibility of a cure. Once the protein bonding process is finalized, I will...
Dr. Young, you ready?
Oh, yes, yes, come in.
You'll hurt my feelings, Doc. Keeping me waiting like that.
Sit down. You can leave us.
You sure?
We're fine. Aren't we, Joker?
Oh, yes! Well, if you insist, I'm just outside, okay?
So is he here? Did your patient X arrive?
Yes,
must say, progressing more rapidly than I expected. But enough of that. Let's talk about you.
No. Let's talk more about your Titan project.
My what? How do you...
How do I know you have been strapped to a table in the basement while you pump him dry? Would you believe a lucky guess?
Yes, I would totally believe a lucky guess. Kind of wish I was fucking with you, but... I could buy it being a lucky guess. There's dead guys all over the place now. It's not good. It's not a good sign. Just bodies everywhere. In we go. It's apparently Amadeus Arkman's obsession with beetles if his fucking interior... if his interior decoration is anything to go by.
I can't waste any time in finding the Titan production plant.
Actually, yeah, we can. This is a video game and there isn't actually a time limit on this. Fuck it, I could spend the next 5 hours doing this.
No idea. Joker's cooking something.
Yeah, and it don't smell good.
Oh, shit.
This is God or something. Messing with people's bodies. He tries that stuff on me, and I quit.
Me too.
Hey, buddies! I wish we could have continued that little conversation. Interesting, hearing someone actually consider rebelling against Joker. Huh. That actually worked. Okay. Like how these guys knock some out on me. That's it. Like, doesn't even do any health damage, really. But with these guys, unconscious. Right. Get some more health, I think. I like my health upgrades.
Patient interview. Hamill Lillian Isley, November 12th, 11:33 a.m. Good morning, Pamela. How are you today?
Fine. Today is a special day.
What do you mean?
This is the anniversary of my new life. When I found my true self, my destiny.
Are you referring to the event with Dr. Woodrow?
Yes. What else? Of course, at the time, I thought Jason had poisoned me. But in retrospect, he did me a huge favor.
And why do you believe what he did has helped you?
He showed me the bigger world. A world I should protect. Of course, my first offer was rejected.
Offer? You tried to kill everyone in Gotham.
Well, sometimes you need to prune back hard in order to make something flourish.
Again, like, Poison Ivy! I don't understand why she's in here. Is she insane? Yeah, probably. But before she's insane, she's also a fucking plant woman. Like, she doesn't belong in an asylum. She belongs in a fucking lab. You know, with people dissecting her, trying to figure out what the fuck happened. Not in a fucking asylum. Reverse the plant shit. Then you can worry about, you know, her mental state, right? But, yeah, so, it's looking like that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble and retarded thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Yes. So, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Let's be honest, I'm not kidding anyone, I don't know if I enjoyed it. I'm a pre-recorded message. Regardless, if you did enjoy it, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below. I do read every comment I get. I need some form of validation for spending as much time as I do making these fucking things. If you want to see more of my stuff, please have a look around my channel. I've been making videos for years now, so there is a lot of content to see. I also try to upload once a day, 5 days a week, often with some side stuff going on over the weekend, so you may want to check that out. If you wish, you can follow me on Twitter, where I've been known to post inane bullshit on a semi-regular basis, and if you're feeling particularly generous, you can always subscribe to my Patreon campaign. Every subscriber on there brings me closer to not having to get off my fat ass and get a real job. And I'll eventually be able to upgrade my PC and all that shit. Well, that's it for this pre-recording. Hope to see you all in the next video. Now, get the fuck out. This one's over. Leave. Now.